Hello, today I'll be creating this animation. So what I have here is two components, one rotating clockwise, the second one rotating in the opposite direction. One component has two layers, the other one just one layer. On each layer I have 8 links. So let's create that HTML structure. So I'm going to have two components, 8 links per layer. And here I'm going to loop. And create the components. And here I'm going to have the total number of links per component. Going to loop again and here I'm going to create the links and now I should have I have this HTML structure. Now let's see how we style this stuff. So we're going to set a width and a height for every link and let's say something like this. Width a height and let's set a background. Okay, now the next thing, let's set for all divs and all pseudo elements. So before and after I need to set position absolute. Okay, now the next thing for the component, I set top 50%, left 50%, and here I'm also going to need to set a margin. This is going to be half the height and minus half the width horizontally. 0.5 times the width. Now something else I need to set here is box sizing, border box. And now let's create the ends. So before and after, I'm going to have top is calc 50%. Minus the diameter. So I'm going to set the diameter here. Minus half the diameter, sorry. Let's say like this. And the radius is going to be half this diameter. So here I'm going to have the radius. And it's going to be similar for the left. Except I'm not going to have 50%. I'm going to have a switch S, which is 0 by default, times 100. And here I'm also going to set the width, and it's going to be the same height. Let's set a content so that we can see stuff, and let's also set a box shadow. And this is going to be an inset one. Inset 0 offset 0 blur and the diameter over 3 spread. Okay, and for the after I switch. So after that switch S is going to be 1. Okay, and something else I need to set here is border radius. 50%. Now the next thing here is set a padding, and this is going to be 0 and the diameter over 3, and this is going to be content box here, Okay, now the next thing, set a transform here. So a transform, and this is going to be rotate calc. And this is why this won't work in Firefox and in Edge, because calc inside rotate isn't supported there. So here I'm going to have an index, which is 0 by default, times a base angle. So I need to interpolate it. So a base angle, and let's compute this base angle here. So I'm going to have the number of links per layer, and here I compute the base angle, which is 360 degrees over the number of links per layer. So now I have the base angle, and this should work here. Something that I need to do is loop here. So for I from 1 to n, I need to have nth child, the number of links per layer, plus I plus 1, and this index here is going to be equal to I. So what's wrong? The number of links. Sorry. Okay. This should be good. Okay, now the next thing is set a translate here. So translate, and I'm going to have again a calc, and this one's going to be the width plus the diameter, and it's going to be multiplied with a multiplier that depends both on the component and on the layer within the component. So I'm going to have J, which is J, which is 0 by default here, plus 2 times K plus 1. K is 0 by default. Okay, and here I'm going to have nth child, and I'm going to have number of links, n plus number of links per layer plus 1, and here I'm going to change K to 1. Okay, so I'm done with multiple layers, and here I'm going to have nth child, 2n, I'm going to have the j is 1. Okay, now I'm going to have an animation here. It's going to be a rotation, 10 seconds, linear, infinite, and now let's see keyframes this rotation, and it goes to transform, rotate, one turn, and it's going to be a calc here, and I'm going to have a multiplier times this one turn, and it's going to be 1 minus 2 times that J. And yeah, this is it. It's this animation from here, and it's done with just 43 lines of code, which is really good. And the generated CSS is, I don't know, probably less than less than 65. So yeah, this is done with CSS custom properties, which really compacts the code. So I hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you have any other ideas for future videos, just drop them in the comments or send them on Twitter, and until next time.